Today's topic is about equivalence of PDA and context-free grammar. We will be seeing in this lecture how a CFG is converted into a PDA equivalent. In the previous topic, we have seen that PDA has been accepted using an empty store, which is equivalent to the PDA accepted by the final state. Now what we are going to find is we are going to find the equivalence between the CFG and PDA. So we are going to prove that the CFG is accepting a string, then the same string will be accepted by PDA using empty store. Similarly, if a string is accepted by PDA by accepting with this empty store, it will be also accepted by the context-free grammar. So let us see how the conversion of CFG to PDA. So let us see the conversion of context-free grammar into PDA using accepting by empty store. So empty store is nothing but empty stack. Okay. So we'll see how a string is going to be accepted. So let us define a language. Let us consider a language. Let L be the language that is generated by the context-free grammar G. Then the language L can be accepted by PDA M accepting by empty store. So what do you mean by this is, if your string is given, that is a set of terminals are given, the context-free grammar, when you derive it, it has to derive to the set of terminals. The same thing, it has to be accepted by the PDA. With a single state, you will try to attain the string which is accepted by the CFG. So let us consider the grammar CFG. So you will have a set of non-terminals, terminals, and a protection rule and a start symbol. Now for this, the PDA will be M. As I said before, with a single state we can do it. So you will have a single state and you will have terminal symbols, set of terminal symbols, and your lambda, which is going to be a set of terminals and non-terminal symbols that are in stack. So we will have terminals and non-terminals together. Then you will have a transition function delta. Your initial state will be Q naught. Your topmost stack symbol will be Z naught. And you don't have a final state since we are going to accept with the empty stack the given string. So you will not be having anything, so it will be equal to pi. So this means this is the PDA that is going to be generated for the given context-free grammar. So how do we convert the context-free production rules into a PDA transition? So first rule, if A tends to beta is a production rule, if it is in P of CFG, and beta, it belongs to set of non-terminals and terminal symbols, then your PDA transition function will be, it is from the state Q naught, there is no element that is to be pushed into stack, and your topmost symbol is A that can contain Q naught beta. So this is your initial state and this will be your push symbol and this will be your pop symbol. So what is done here is the A is being replaced with beta. If beta is about a set of non-terminals, for example, if A tends to B, C D A B, then the leftmost non-terminal will be the topmost of the stack. For example, if you have A, so A will be replaced in such a fashion. So B, A, D, C, and B. You can see B will be the topmost of the symbol. So here the beta, the leftmost symbol becomes the top of the stack, becomes top of the stack. Now the second rule is, suppose you have a terminal symbol. So for each terminal symbol in T, then your transition function is tau q naught a comma a, then you will perform a pop operation. So you will be performing a pop operation. So this refers to pop operation. So this refers to the pop operation. So here the current input is a, and the top of the stack is also a terminal symbol a, then you will perform pop. For example, if a tends to ab, and if your stack is consist of a, this a and this a will get popped from the stack. So using these two rules, you will form a transition function such that the string will be accepted using empty stack. So let us see an example how a PDA is constructed for the given CFG. So let us formulate the PDA. So PDA M. So we said we are going to accept with the empty store. So you will need only one state. So you will have Q naught. Then the terminal symbols in the given grammar are going to be A and B. And the stack will be consisting of non-terminals and terminals. So here non-terminal is S and terminals are A and B. So initial state will be Q naught, and we'll assume the top of the stack consists of the starting symbol of the production. So that is going to be S. And we are going to accept with the empty store, which is going to be 5. Right, now we'll start with the transition. So we know what is the rule is. So if there is a production rule A tends to B, we can write with the transition function in this fashion. So you will be writing it as tau q naught epsilon, no symbol is going to be pushed into stack, with the starting symbol S, which will be equal to, you can see S can give two productions, right hand side is ASB and AB. So you will write two transitions, q naught ASB and q naught AB. So now you can see from a single state I have two transitions, so hence this is a non-deterministic PDA. Since a single state for the same input it has two transition to two different states, then it is considered as a non-deterministic. So here this PDA is also a non-deterministic fashion. You can see Q naught for epsilon and S symbol, it has two transition. The first transition it goes to Q naught ASB, and second transition it goes for Q naught AB, right? So the transition for the production rule we have done. Next we have to write the transition function for the terminal symbols. So what are the terminal symbols? We have AA and transition Q naught B and B. So which will be Q naught epsilon. So only the pop-up operation will be performed in the stack. Now let us see how a string is accepted. For example, let us consider a string AAA, BBB. Why I am writing AAA and BBB is, you can see S can be replaced with AAB. So the language accepted is going to be AABB, and you can have multiple A's and multiple B's. Okay, it goes on. Right, so you can see the number of A's and number of B's are same in the direction, and A should come first and B should come next. Now if that is the case, let us assume if I have a stack. Let me draw the stack first. So when you start reading with the first symbol, you can see it is a terminal symbol, whereas in this top of the stack you have S. So as per the symbol non-terminal, you have to replace. To accept the string, I will replace with the first production. So S will be replaced. See how it is written. The leftmost symbol must be the top of the stack, so you will have A, S and B. So this is the topmost stack. Now here A and here A. So if it is going to be input is A and the top of the stack is A, you have to pop. So A will be popped. Okay, so A will be popped. So the next symbol is A. Again, you are non-terminal, you have to accept. So you will replace S by again A, S, B. Now the top of the stack is A, so this A and this A will get removed. Now again I need another A, so you can use A as B, but if S is replaced, again S can be replaced with A, B, so I will replace with A, B. So you will have A, B and B. So here this next A, so this will and this will get terminated. Next you have only triple B in your thing, so the first B and first B gone, then you will have two B's. Then the final B is removed from the stack. Now you can see my stack is empty. So the given string is accepted by empty store without reaching the final state. So there is no final state here with the empty store. We are trying to solve this. So let us go for the proof. So how to prove this? So we know that the PDA can stimulate a leftmost derivation of the context-free grammar. So in order to prove this, what you are going to do here is a string which is accepted by the context-free grammar, then it should be also accepted by the PDA. And we have to prove it in the vice versa also. If a string is accepted by PDA, then it should be accepted by the context-free grammar. So let us take the first case. We'll be taking a string is that is accepted by the context-free grammar. So in the context-free grammar, you will be having a set of production rules. For example, if you derivate in a leftmost fashion, it has to end with a terminal symbol, that is either with a string. So if you consider, then this S tends to lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 up to lambda n, which can finally derive the string. So each lambda 1 is going to be a leftmost derivation. So the leftmost derivation will be of three parts. One is going to be xi, a, alpha I. So what is xi is? Xi will be a set of strings, a set of terminals, and A will be the leftmost non-terminal, and alpha will be the rest of the terminal. For example, if you take the example, A tends to small a, small b, capital B, A, capital A, B. So here, the small a, b will be x, and the b will be a, and the rest of the terms will be alpha. So you will refer this term as xi. So you will consider that leftmost derivation or leftmost production will be of two parts. So one is going to be xi and another one is going to be yi. So what is yi is? Yi is going to be a alpha I dash. So that is the rest leftmost symbol that will occur with the nonmost. So this is a non-terminal and this will be either terminal or non-terminal. So in this way we are going to substitute. So xi will be processed because you will have popping up operation for all the terminal symbols. So xi will be processed and yi has to be processed. When yi has to be processed, the first non-terminal will be replaced with its own production, and again until the string is getting accepted. Hence your transition function will be tau of q naught comma w will be deriving yi alpha I. So yi is going to be, so as I said before, if your leftmost derivation will be divided into xi and yi, so yi will be consisting of a alpha i. So you will be, yi is processed, then you will have only alpha I needed to be processed. So that is what mentioned here. Now we will use the induction. We will start with the base condition. If you directly derive to the terminal symbol, then you will have lambda 1 will be your S and xi and will be equal to epsilon and yi will be the terminal symbols alone. So you will have directly derived to this. So here alpha I will be same as the top of the stack. Now we want to prove that if you have multiple productions in your context-free grammar, how do we do it? So each production should be replaced by this. So if S tends to lambda 1, then it tends to lambda 2. It can be derived to with lambda 2. Then it can be derived with lambda 3 up lambda n. So if that is the case, what you will do is in each lambda xi will be processed and yi will be taken up for this. So this yi will be the term for lambda 2. So lambda 2 will have x2 and y2. Again y2 will be processed and this will be the lambda 3. So this will be y2 for lambda 3. So lambda 3 again will have two paths, so that will be x3 and y3. So you can see each in which x1 is processed, then y1 will become lambda 2, and in processing every lambda you will be having x and long, the terminal symbols has to be processed. So what I do is to prove it can be solved with a I process or n steps. So when you have string I plus 1 and I plus 1, you have to prove that it is to belongs to, so all the production substitution, I will take x of I, y of I. So x of I is going to be set of terminals, and the y of I leftmost will be a non-terminal followed by terminal and non-terminal. So in that case, xi will be processed. You will be left with yi and the remaining part of the symbols. So let us consider if a tends to x and y. So if x is processed, now y should be replaced. So y can be of other two parts like beta 1, beta 2, alpha I. So beta 1 is a terminal and beta 2 will be a non-terminal, and it will be of process. So you will take, instead of y, I will taking as beta. So you can see beta 1 and beta 1 will get popped as per the PDA definition transition. Now you will be left out with the remaining parts of the first right side production, and this will be of right side production. So you can see in beta this part will be processed. So here again you will take this one as x y I plus 1, and the remaining terms alpha will be as y I plus 1. So you will be processed with xi, then yi plus 1 plus beta 2 alpha dash. So this is nothing but the alpha part for this one. So hence you will be deriving to yi plus 1 and alpha I dash plus 1. So the last test case is from the starting symbol, I can directly derive the string. So if that is going to be the case, what will be the, so it's the last step. Okay. So if it is going to be the last step, you can see that there will be no leftmost derivation. That is, the y part will be empty. So if y part is empty, alpha will be also empty. Only existence you will have is the x part alone. So the x part will be the exact terminal symbol which is to be accepted. So you can see x of n is going to be w of n. When we start deriving from s, lambda n will be giving x of n and alpha n. So here alpha n is empty. So you will have x of n alone. So we know that x of n is going to directly give the string which is required. So it is deriving w. So when there is only non-terminal operation, the transition will only perform the empty of popping operation from the stack. So when the final non-terminal string is accepted, you can see my stack will be empty with no symbols. So this is the acceptance of PDA by empty store. Now we will go for the second case. If a string is accepted by PDA, then it should be accepted by the context-free grammar. So if a string is accepted by PDA, then you will have a transition function that QXA, X is the input string and A is the initial topmost symbol. Okay, then you can derive it to the empty of the stack because we will be accepting using empty store. So here we have to show that A can be derived from, that is the W can be or X can be derived from A. So you'll replace this. Okay, this is x. So x can be derived from A. So we need to prove how many number of steps that PDA would take to accept the string. So the first move will be if there is a production that A tends to beta, then you will be having a transition function that alpha q I alpha will be equal to empty string. So here A can be a non-terminal symbol, and if it is beta, then it will be replaced with Q naught alpha beta. If A is going to be epsilon, then you will be having epsilon moves with the non-terminal symbol. So you can derive A implies epsilon. So now that we will see the induction portion, if we have to prove that it is also true for n minus 1, because in the previous we have done with the first move. So we have done for the first move here. So here we are going to do for n minus 1 steps. So that will be also true only if we have a production that A tends to lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n. If that is the case, then you will have a transition function Q naught will be epsilon A to Q naught with epsilon 1, epsilon 2 up to epsilon 3, lambda 1, lambda 2 up to lambda k. So here what you are seeing is, when you see in the graph, if lambda 1 is getting processed here, xi is completed and yi is left. So that means xi, x1 is processed and y1 yet to get processed. After few steps of process are doing with after derivations, leftmost derivations, here x2 will be processed and y2 is yet to be processed. So in this way, when you come here, all the xn will be processed and y2 will become epsilon. So you will have only xn alone will be here. So if that is the case, then you will have theta can be derived to a empty stack. So this will take n minus one step. So with the induction hypothesis, we can say ya can be deriving to xi, that is set of terminal symbols, that is your input string. So if this is true, one and if and only if you have a production that a tends to y1, y2, yk. So that means in each y1, before processing y1, x1 will be processed, here x2 will be processed, and finally when you come for the last term, xk will be processed and yk will be equal to epsilon. Yk will be equal to epsilon. So with that condition, we can say the starting symbol a can derive the input string x here. Now we'll see the initial condition. So what is the initial condition? We gave q0 ws which can derive into a empty stack. If this is possible, then s can derive the input string. So I have proved that the if a string is accepted by the PDA, then that string can be derived from the context free grammar with the initials with the starting state symbol. So let us see an example. So we are going to construct an PDA in equivalent for the given context free grammar. So first step, what is the given grammar? So the given grammar, in given grammar, what are the terminal symbols and non-terminal symbols we have? So the terminal symbols or non-terminal symbols are going to be S and A, and my terminal symbols are going to be A and B. So your step two is you have to formulate the PDA. So the PDA M is going to be, so you said we can accept with a single state, so you'll have Q0, your terminal symbols are A and B, your stack symbols can be S, A and B. So then you have to find the transition function, your initial state will be Q0, and your topmost symbol will be the starting symbol of the grammar, which is S, and we are going to accept with the empty string. Okay, so we'll define, now the step three is to define the tau function. So we have to define the tau functions. So we have to define it. So first thing is we'll take with the starting symbol. So Q0 epsilon, nothing is to be inserted, S. Now this can be equal to Q0, as I said, if there is a production from S to a non-terminal to a production, then it should be replaced with the non-terminal. So it will be A. Similarly, what are the other non-terminals we have? We have A, so you'll have A which gives Q0 AS as a first production, again Q0 with BS as a second production, and Q0 with AS as a third production. So you can see it is a non-deterministic push down automata, since for Q0 with the topmost symbol A, you can have three transitions. So it is a non-deterministic PDA. Okay, keep that in mind. Now we have to write the transition symbol for the terminal symbols. If input is A and the top off is A, you have to pop. So you will have a pop symbol. Similarly, if it is B and if it is B, then it is also going to be a pop symbol. So now this is the equivalent PDA for the given context-free grammar. So now we are going to have another example. Now in this example, we have a given with a context-free grammar and we have to find a PDA and we have to process the input string, that is AABC. So first, we'll form the step one. So grammar, the CFG grammar, in that your terminal symbols are S, A, B and capital C, your non-terminals, and what is the terminal symbols? You have small a, small b and small c. Okay, so step two, so what will be step two? You have to formulate the PDA. So let me formulate PDA. So you can have a single step state, so it is going to be Q, your terminal symbols are A, B, C, your stack symbols are going to be S, A, B, C, A, B, C. Okay, and you have to find the tau function. Okay, then you have to find your initial state will be Q, your top of the stack will be the stack symbol of the grammar, which is going to be S, and we are going to process with the empty string. Now we are, the step three is to define the tau function. So we'll define the tau function. So we'll start with all non-terminals first. So tau, Q, epsilon, S. So which will be having only one production, which is AA. So you will have Q, AA. So next one is tau, Q, epsilon, A. If A is the symbol, I can have three productions. So let me write Q, small a, b, c. Then you can have Q, b, b. And you can have Q, a. So three productions. Then with epsilon b, you can have Q, b. And with epsilon c, non-terminal, then you will have Q, c. Now we will write the transition functions for terminal symbols. So if it is Q AA, you have to pop. So Q epsilon tau Q BB will be again a pop operation, Q epsilon, and tau Q CC will be also Q epsilon. So let me process the string. Okay, for processing the string. A, B, C. So we'll start pushing it into the tau symbol. So we'll write in this fashion with the triplet Q, comma, triple A, B, C, comma, with the start symbol S. So you will have, if it is a terminal and here it's a non-terminal, then you have to use the first rule. So number one, this is two, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so you will using 7, so you will be using Q triple A B C A A. So this is because of 1. Okay, now you have A and A, so here A and here A, pop operation will be performed. So you will have Q double A B C capital A. So this is because of the rule number or transition function 5. So next thing, I'll write it over here a little bit. So A can be replaced. So you will have Q A A B C. I can write A A B C. Okay, now this is because of the rule number 2 with the first production. Now again, you have A and UA will be pop. So you will have Q A B C and you will have capital A B C. Now this is because of rule number 5. Okay, and now A can be replaced with the last transition. So you will have Q comma A B C A B C. So this is because of rule 2. Then you have A and you have A, so we will pop. So you will have Q B C B C. Now this will be transmitted into Q B C comma B capital C. So this again and again same. So finally B and B will get cancelled, popped out. So you will have Q C capital C, and that will give Q C comma C. Finally you will have Q comma epsilon comma epsilon. So you can see I have reached the empty of the string. Hence the given string is accepted by the PDA. Now this is the last example. You will be given with a language for the context free grammar. So first you have to find the context free grammar, and for that context free grammar you have to find the equivalent PDA. So first thing is you have to find what is the language is. So the language will be is n should be always less than m. So if n is equal to 1, a will be 2. So a square b, then you will have a cube b square, a 4 b cube, and also you can have a cube b, a 4 b. Similarly anything can be formed. So you can see the first thing is a square s, so we'll write this term, so a square b, that means we will write it as aab. Okay, so you can see here the middle term, it can be replaced, so I will write s tends to asb, and the middle term it can have a, so or a, sometimes it can be of combinations also, like aaa and bb, so it can be of replacement, so it can also have as, so it's again the replacement of the first term as with multiple a, because a is getting improved. So now this is the grammar. So we will form the PDA equivalent. Step one, we know that the only non-terminal here is s and the terminal symbols are a and b. So step two, we have to form the equivalent PDA. So m is going to be, we can accept with a single state, you have terminal symbols a and b and your stack symbols are a, s and b. Then you have to define tau, then you have to initial function is status q, the topmost symbol will be the starting symbol of the grammar, yes, and you have to go into accept with the empty store. Now we will define, so where tau will be defined as, so only non-terminal is s, so q naught epsilon, okay, so we don't use q naught, we have used q here. So q comma epsilon comma s, which is going to give q comma asb, that is one term, and q comma a is second term, and q comma as as a third term. So that's the only thing. So only non-terminal we have is s, we have defined a tau function for that. Next we have to define for the terminal symbols, so it is going to be a pop-up operation. And it is BB, it is going to be also a pop-up operation. So this is the equivalent PDA for the given language AM, BM. Thank you. We will meet with a new topic in the next session.